Colon cancer can be prevented, and here with the information that could save your life is Dr. David Dietz from the Cleveland Clinic. And this is one of those cancers, if everyone did what they were supposed to do, they might put you out of business.
That's exactly right. There's a lot of good evidence that colorectal cancer screening detects polyps, which is the precancerous lesion for almost all colon cancers. We can remove those polyps, and then thus we can prevent colon cancer from occurring.
So it's all about awareness, and I noticed somebody said they're turning the terminal tower a different color to make everybody stop and think a minute that maybe they should call and get a colonoscopy, perhaps.
That's right. Tonight, I think the tower will be turned blue. March 4th is today. March, of course, is Colon Cancer Awareness Month. At the Cleveland Clinic, we have a campaign underway called the March 4th campaign. It's F-O-R-T-H rather than fourth like the number. Meant to try and encourage people to get colonoscopies. They can visit the Cleveland Clinic website, March 4th. There's a lot of information there about colorectal cancer screening, how to prevent it, what to do if you get diagnosed with colorectal cancer. And there's also a risk assessment tool, which the patient can fill out a few simple questions, and it'll give them an idea of what their risk for developing colorectal cancer is.
So that would indicate at what age or how soon you should actually get your first colorectal exam or a colonoscopy?
That's correct. Most patients, those who are average risk, should start screening at the age of 50.
50?
50, correct. Now, patients sometimes develop symptoms such as rectal bleeding, and they should notify their doctor about that and let their doctor make the decision as to whether or not they ought to have a colonoscopy maybe earlier than anticipated.
So everybody at 50, even if you think you're 100% healthy, and then how often should you repeat that procedure?
Colorectal cancer takes a while to develop. We think it's about 10 years from the time a polyp first starts to develop until it turns into a cancer. So if that colonoscopy at age 50 is normal, no polyps, then the patient doesn't have to come back for 10 years.
So when you find polyps in an exam, is that something you can fix right away, or the patient has to return, or how does that work?
Right. Now, one of the advantages of colonoscopy as a screening tool is that we can actually remove the polyp when we detect it. And that's key to preventing cancers. If you look back around 2000, we weren't doing a very good job screening patients. Less than one out of five Americans were getting appropriate screening. Nowadays, we're up over 50%. And what's interesting is that the rate of colorectal cancer in the United States has declined about 30% during that period of time, which really underlines the effectiveness of the approach.
It sounds like they've made more headway with this cancer than any other.
Yeah, it's a very preventable cancer. In fact, there's research that suggests that if every patient in the United States got appropriate screening, we'd probably cut the rate of colon cancer in half.
And I hear a lot of people, they make a joke out of going to get a colonoscopy, how terrible it is and how difficult it is. How bad is it? How difficult is it?
It's not. The procedure itself is not too difficult. Patients get medication to relax them for the procedure. The prep is probably the most difficult.
Are you talking about the day before?
Right, the day before. You have to drink some liquid. You have to clean out the colon so we can see things and detect polyps. Small polyps sometimes are hard to see.
Yeah.
That's why it's important to have a very experienced endoscopist do the procedure, someone who does a lot of colonoscopy, does a lot of screening to make sure they're going to find things that we're looking for.
Yeah, I did a long time ago, and probably due to do it again, but the one thing I noticed was when you actually have this done, it's like you don't even know you did it,
right?
And you're in great shape. I mean, you feel fine afterwards. And
right. Most people get very worked up beforehand, but
yeah, I did.
They always tell you afterwards that, hey, doc, it wasn't nearly as bad as I thought.
That was me. That was the voice I had. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thanks
Dr.
for having
Dietz, me. Cleveland Clinic. Okay.